Salve Regina, Mater misericordiae, Vita dulcedo, et spes nostra salve. A te clamamus, exules filii Eve, a te suspiramus, gementes et plentes, in ac lacrimarum.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome. Today is Friday of the fourth week of the year. Several things to note. First, before we talk about the readings, I'm going to be praying for all the people really affected again by this double whammy of the big storms that ran from way up in the East Coast all the way down into Texas, and it's still happening. We pray for all those affected. Secondly, we want to pray, obviously, as the Olympics kick off in a very strange way, you know, in that little bubble that they've created. Father Lee was mentioning how one of Superior's own got to carry in the flag last night. So that was kind of neat to hear about. So just a great little piece of the story of the Winter Olympics. So I want to pray for people around the world. Now, on this Friday of the fourth week of the year, so for the 4 weeks now, we've been in this journey about King David. And yesterday we heard how David had died. And today, in this first reading that Bernie's going to share with us, it's kind of like a eulogy. It really is. It's a recap of his life. I'm going to listen to it. I'm going to talk about that in the homily today. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. My dear friends, let us call to mind our sin, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us and forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Let us pray. Grant us, Lord our God, that we may honor you with all our mind and love everyone in truth of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Sirach. Like the choice fat of the sacred offerings, so was David in Israel. He made sport of lions as though they were kids, and of the bears like lambs of the flock. As a youth, he slew the giant and wiped out the people's disgrace. When his hand let fly the slingshot that crushed the pride of Goliath, since he called upon the Most High God, who gave him the right arm to defeat the skilled lawyer and raise up the might of his people. Therefore, the women sang his praises and ascribed to him tens of thousands and praised him when they blessed the Lord. When he assumed the royal crown, he battled and subdued the enemy on every side. He destroyed the hostile Philistines and shattered their power till their own day. When his every deed he offered thanks to God Most High in words of praise. When his whole being he loved his Maker, and daily he had his praises sung. He set singers before the altar, and by their voices he made sweet melodies. He added beauty to the feasts and solemnized the seasons of every year, so that when the holy name was praised, before daybreak, the sanctuary would resound. The Lord forgave him his sins and exalted his strength forever. He conferred on him the rights of royalty and established his throne in Israel. The word of the Lord. The responsorial song. Blessed be God, my Savior.
Blessed be God, my Savior.
God's way is unerring. The promise of the Lord is fire tried. He is a shield to all who take refuge in him. Blessed be God, my salvation. The Lord live, and blessed be his rock. Extolled be my God, Savior. Therefore, I will proclaim you, O Lord, among the nations, and I will sing praise to your holy name. Blessed be God, my salvation. Yet, who has great victories in your king and showed kindness in your anointing to David in his posterity forever? Blessed be God, my salvation.
From the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory
to you, O Lord. King Herod heard about Jesus, for his fame had become widespread, and people were saying, John the Baptist has been raised from the dead. That is why mighty powers are at work in him. Others were saying, he's Elijah. Still others, he's a prophet, like any of the prophets. But when Herod learned of it, he said, it's John whom I beheaded. He's been raised up. Herod was the one who had John arrested and bound in prison on account of Herodias, the wife of his brother Philip, whom he had married. John had said to Herod, It is not lawful for you to have your brother's wife. Herodias harbored a grudge against John and wanted to kill him, but was unable to do so. Herod feared John, knowing him to be a righteous and holy man, and kept him in custody. When he heard him speak, he was very much perplexed, yet he did like to listen to him. Herodias had an opportunity one day when Herod, on his birthday, gave a banquet for his courtiers, his military officers, and the leading men of Galilee. His own daughter came in and performed a dance that delighted Herod and the guests. The king said to the girl, "Ask of me whatever you wish, I'll grant it to you." He even swore many things to her. "I'll grant you whatever you ask of me, even to half my kingdom." She went out and said to her mother, "What shall I ask for?" Her mother replied, "The head of John the Baptist." The girl hurried back to the king's presence and made her request, "I want you to give me at once on a platter the head of John the Baptist." The king was deeply distressed, but because of his oath and the guests, he did not wish to break his word to her. So he promptly dispatched an executioner with orders to bring back his head. He went off and beheaded him in the prison. He brought in the head on a platter and gave it to the girl. The girl in turn gave it to her mother. When his disciples heard about it, they came and took his body and laid it in a tomb.
The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In my years as a parish priest, of course, I've done a lot of funerals, and I've heard a lot of eulogies. And so as I was looking at this reading today, and this is taken out of the book of Sirach, it's a summary of some of the high points of David's life. And if you've been following the readings that we've had these last 4 weeks, you really do see all the high points that are mentioned here. It certainly isn't everything, but it gives you a sketch, an overview of this incredible figure in the Old Testament. David's role, he dominates this, showing up in all of these different books of the Old Testament, his lasting impact, the gift of the Psalms. He has so many different ways in which his influence has been felt. So you have here what really does look like a eulogy, capturing a lot of the elements of his life. From the time he was a shepherd boy, you know, taking on the bears and the lions to protect the sheep, his role as a king, the great deed he did with Goliath, but then the way in which he built up the kingdom. And then he created for the people opportunities to worship the Lord. But what I also love about this is that it's not set with gold gilding. It does honor also the fact that at the very end you hear the Lord forgave him his sins. There's a recognition. He did a lot of good, but there was also some struggles. And God was with him every step of the way. That over these last few weeks, for those who've been listening to all the different homilies I've been giving on this, you talk about how the life is messy. Life is difficult. And yes, it's not all horrible. It's not all good. There's a mix. There's a little sunshine and there's a little rain. God walked with David from the high points to the low points. Friends, God does the same with us. Now, I often wonder, you know, when I work with like kids and I teach confirmation for the high school kids, I'll often say, hey, look, I bring out an obituary that often will highlight what somebody did in their life. I said, now look, what do you want to be known for? What do you want to be your legacy? Because you've been given a gift to walk this earth, to have a life. And what do you want people, when they think about you, to say? Do you want to know that the world was a little bit better because the air you breathed didn't just take up space and time? Do you want to be a gift, a blessing? And so when you give kids a chance to think about it, you start to say, what do you want to be remembered for? How do you want your life to make a difference? How do you want to share the gift of your life? And it doesn't have to be in some big, fancy way, but to make a difference with that group of people we call family, or that group of people we call friends, or work that we do that helps and brings joy, whatever it is. David made a difference, and yet David, with his imperfections, still walked with God. And folks, that's our hope, that as we strive to make a difference in the world, to offer our lives, to take this sacred gift and live it, we call upon the Lord, that we can celebrate the successes, and when we fall flat on our face, we turn to Christ and say, Lord, help me here, forgive me here, and help me to learn and grow. That as David made an offering of his life, we know all too well, because the scriptures state it, he had plenty of sins. We do too. And yet we call upon the Lord with the same kind of fervent faith that was clearly evident in David's life. And we ask the Lord out of that same strong desire, Lord, help us, enliven us, empower us to be your sons and daughters bringing light into the world. Friends, sooner or later, God calls us all home. Sooner or later, the story of our life here on earth will come to a close. May we make each day a precious gift and offering. It's given to us by the Lord.
May we live that offering with a full heart. May we allow this example of David to inspire us, not to give up when we make mistakes, but instead to turn to Jesus. And in moments of joy and peace, to thank the Lord for all we've been given. After all, this precious gift of life is meant to be lived. May we put it into practice each and every day. God bless you all. We pray this day for the church, that we will be living examples of faith, hope, and love as we follow Christ our Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
pray for troubled spots around the world that struggle with poverty, violence, and war, especially for those places where people suffer from basic needs, injustices, and oppression. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear my prayer.
For the safety and success of the Olympic Games, that it goes well in the face of the precautions that are being taken, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear my prayer.
For all our brothers and sisters out on the East Coast, from Maine all the way down to Texas, affected by these last storms, that they be safe. And for those who have suffered, that God will bless and protect them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear my prayer.
For all who are sick, for all who could use a little healing, comfort, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear my prayer.
The Mass intention today is for Ronald Rubel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of you at home, for the prayers you offer in the comment line, for all of us, for the prayers we now offer in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious and loving God, look kindly upon us. Hear the prayers we offer now, spoken and silent. We make them all in the name of Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
O God, we earnestly ask you to bless our diocese with many priests, brothers, sisters, and deacons who will love you with their whole mind and heart and gladly spend their entire lives serving your church and making you known and loved. Bless our families, bless our children, and choose from our homes those needed for your work. Mary, Queen of the Clergy, pray for us. Pray for our priests, religious, and deacons. Obtain for us many more. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our loving Father. Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so in company with the choirs of angels, We praise you and with joy we proclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, James, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. And have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her husband, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress and useless worry, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of the Father,
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Nourished by these redeeming gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, true faith may ever increase through Christ our Lord. Amen. Some announcements. So a word out to just the internet in general, but to folks here, the school, Cathedral School's open house, showing families, registration information, packets, is this coming Monday, February 7th. 5 to 6:30. I want to invite people, get the word out, have them check things out, and so they can see the school. I also want to invite people to go online to the diocesan webpage to input your thoughts that we're asking for about the World Synod. There are 6 questions, and in those 6 questions, we really want to hear from people. And get this, from anybody, from anybody who's in our diocese, whether they're Catholic, Christian, non-practicing, don't believe in anything. We still would want to hear where different people are coming from. We want to hear. Pope Francis wants to get a sense of where people are right now so that we can honestly assess how we can share the good news of Jesus in a relevant way. So in order to do that, we have to hear from folks. A reminder, I'm going to be having a listening session here in person for the whole cluster. That's going to be on Saturday, February, whatever that is, 12th, I think. But I'll have that announcement on the weekend. My point right now is to invite people to do the online format. It's fast, it's easy, and very efficient. For those of you at home, keep sharing these masses. It's the way we get the word out, and you're making it possible. Please stand.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Have a great day.